everybody, how are you? Evan Gonzalez here. Welcome back to Inspiract. We're doing something brand new every single day that I have never done before. Today we have a great subject for Social Media Sunday. Originally, I was going to just teach about Facebook privacy settings. You know, when you first sign up, they're all in default. And anybody can see all of your information. So for some people, that's really scary. But I'm here to tell you today that for those of you who think it's really scary and that the privacy issue is a big deal, I think you should quit your crying. Okay? I'm going to do my best to use some metaphors to help you explain why Facebook is really just an extension of your real life. It is your real life. It is not a virtual life. And show you why, you know, it's understandable. People don't feel comfortable with the way their information is getting displayed and shared around the web right now. But that's just a change. And, you know, normally there's some resistance to change. But Facebook and social media are going to be around for a very, very long time. I think they're here to stay. And so we got to get used to playing by the rules and understanding how things work here. So like I said, I want to use some metaphors to help explain to you why social media and the privacy settings are no different than the privacy settings that you put on your real life. It's up to you to really decide, do I want to be completely private? Do I want people to be able to search me? Or do I want to be completely open? Here's something for all you internet marketers, bloggers, MLMers, everybody out there trying to do business on the web. You're going to do a lot better when your profile is set to all options open. Everybody can see everything. I want you to think about it like this. Think about body language. When you see somebody and you want to approach somebody, talk to them or get information from them, whatever, you see this person like this, what does that mean? It means they don't want to talk, right? They're going to be more closed off than if there was a person that was hanging out like this. And I would liken that to somebody's profile who is wide open and sharing. So when you see somebody's profile that has a lot of information on it, definitely feel like that person's a more open person, right? Versus somebody that has it all closed off, all privacy locked, etc., you definitely think of that person as more of a closed person. So keep that in mind when you're an internet blogger, internet marketer, etc. So people are all worked up about the privacy thing. They want to know, like, oh, I don't want people getting that information. You put all the information on there you want to put on there. So quit crying about it. You don't want people to see your address? Don't put your address on there. You don't want people to see your photos? Don't put your photos on there. You don't want your boss to see what you're doing Friday night? Don't post on Facebook what you're doing Friday night. Jesus. Come on, people. Don't get upset about things that you are in full control of. So yeah, Facebook has changed the privacy issues. Well, it's totally up to you what you're putting on the web. I always think about it in terms of what would your mom say, you know? Would you post that or would you tell your mom that? Or your daughter? Your kids? So think about these things. Also want to use another metaphor for social media. When you go out to a bar, or you go out to a concert, or you just go out to the grocery store, when you're driving on the way there, or even when you're in the store, you bump into 50 people, 100 people. You may not talk to all of them, but the same thing is true on social media. You see a feed. You see people commenting on other people's stuff. You see their picture. You may not talk to them. You may not go to their profile, anything. You just skimmed right by them. So how is that any different than walking by somebody at the grocery store and not saying hello? Seems to me like you're pretty open when you're out in the open. You give it out to everybody. When you make that choice to walk out your front door and go to public, that is the same thing as logging out of Facebook and putting all your information out there. Okay, if that metaphor still doesn't ring true for you, why don't you consider this? When you go to a new workplace, or you start a new class at school, or whatever, you're in a new situation, new scenery, new setup, you are choosing your privacy settings, okay? Like when I got into graduate school, the first 2 weeks, I was a pretty reserved person. You know, I was feeling it out. I wasn't sure what I wanted people to know about me. I wasn't sure what I wanted to tell people, etc. You know, I set up my own privacy settings. So, my point is, in real life, you choose how you want to be seen. You choose, you know, what you're saying, what you're doing, etc. The same thing is true on social media and on the web here. That's why people need to quit crying about privacy issues, privacy settings. You know, maybe I'm a young, naive person, and, you know, I haven't had all the world experience, etc., or whatever. Maybe I'm just a person that doesn't really have that many secrets. You know, maybe that's why I don't have a big problem with it. But really, when it comes down to it, you choose what you share. So quit crying about privacy settings on Facebook. Okay, I got a little intense, got worked up. But, you know, sometimes you have to put it in terms that people are going to understand. So I wanted to ask you a question for next week's Social Media Sunday. What do you want to talk about? I was considering Facebook for Dummies and was really thinking about maybe teaching my mom and some of her friends some Facebook stuff, because I feel like, you know, I take it for granted that I know certain things on here, but I had to learn all these things first. And so passing that along is something that I would like to do with Social Media Sunday. And the other option that I wanted to present for next Social Media Sunday is why video blogging is not the best way to connect with people via social media or the internet. You know that I'm a big video blogger, so you're probably wondering, like, what's it you want to talk about? But trust me, it's a very important topic that I think a lot of bloggers today need to hear. Anyway, that's it for Social Media Sunday. I will catch you next week. Please let me know what you would like to see next week in the comments. I think that's it. That's a wrap. Take care. Be easy. Consider it this way. If you're worried about safety from like a physical standpoint, where are you more safe? At home, hiding behind your computer? Or out in the world, on the freeway? Or out getting drinks with friends late at night downtown? To make it hot. Electric shock, energy like a billion.